I don't know, aunt. For the first time, it was that Champa told me that
you... Don't lie to me.
Look, kid. Tell us frankly, where have they gone?
I am telling the truth, uncle. I don't know anything. Well, Champa was crying a lot and she said that she had to return Lalan's book or else he would fail in his exams.
You are a big liar.
Champa's mom, why are you scolding her? You couldn't take care of your own daughter.
Don't force me to say something, Krishna. People know everything how you took care of Rani. Were you able to look after her? Finally, she committed suicide.
There is no point in arguing. Anandi will never tell us anything. Let's go and look for them.
Right. If we get hold of that boy, we will punish him then and there.
Come, let's look for him at the bus depot.
Let's go.
Listen, you stay right here. Champa's mother is in shock. She's crying so much. We will deal with him. Let's go. Come on.
If they find Champa with that ruffian, I'll kill her myself.
What's the problem? Why have all of you gathered here?
Anandi, are you all right? Nothing will happen to her, Bhagwati. Anandi helped my daughter elope with Lallan.
Well, Bhagwati, you know the confectioner, Anantram, his son Lallan, her daughter eloped with him.
Why are you blaming my daughter? Whom else should I blame? She had come here to meet Anandi. Ask her if you don't believe me.
Anandi dear, what is all this? Are they telling the truth?
Champa's mother had beaten her up badly. She was crying a lot. She told me that her mother won't let her meet Lallan. You call him here.
Did you hear that? That's what we have been asking her. She spoke the truth at last. Did you call that guy here?
Yes.
Put some sense in your daughter's head, Khajan Singh. She too is married. If her in-laws get to know of this, her marriage could be in trouble.
Stop worrying about other girls. Think of your daughter first.
Why did you interfere? We had told you to stay inside the house.
Anandi, I had warned you against meeting Champa. You disobeyed me. Why did you listen to her? These villagers are cursing your parents now. Does that make you happy?
They are lying. When they say that Champa eloped, why would she do that? She just wanted to return Lalan's book, but her mother stopped her. After all, she's stepmother. Oh God! Such a small girl is calling me names in front of everyone.
Is that what I have taught you? How dare you speak to your elders like this? Aren't you ashamed?
Champa only told me that her stepmother beats her a lot.
How dare you argue with me?
Bhagwati!
Why did you slap me? What wrong have I done, Mom?
You called that ruffian here and helped Champa elope? And you're asking me what's your mistake?
I didn't help her elope.
Really? Don't argue with me. Now you're back answering me.
Hey, what are you doing, Bhagwati? Why are you hitting this innocent girl? Hitting a daughter in public? It's not good, you see. Besides that, what is this poor girl's fault?
She encouraged Champa to run away from home. She helped her elope with that ruffian.
What? This innocent girl? How can you even think like this? This innocent girl does not even know. What does it mean for a girl to elope with a guy? Hey, Anandi's parents are still alive. When you don't know what has happened, you better not interfere. Come on, go to your place. Go home.
And what if I don't? What will you do? You're gonna kill me? Or else you will ostracize me? Or will you throw me out of the village? That's what you had done to Sandhya, madam.
Purushottam, you're crossing your limits.
Yes,
that's right. Pardon me.
Am I saying something wrong? You stop people from speaking the truth. Khajand, when children grow up, their likes and dislikes change, doesn't it? Someone who has her entire life ahead of her is bound to have certain dreams. If you had got her married at the right age, then your Champa would not have felt the need to elope.
That's enough. Stop lecturing us. Come on, friends, let's go. Let's not waste time listening to his nonsense.
Come on, let's go now.
How many lives of such little girls are you going to ruin like this? And if you want to continue doing this, then I have a request. As soon as a girl is born to anyone in this village, dig a well and throw her in it.
Darn you, keep quiet. I say...
But what will happen to my Champa?
We'll look for her. We won't be able to catch them if they go too far.
Yes, come,
yes, come,
come on,
let's go.
Let's go, hurry up. Let's go. Bhagwati? Oh, there you are, and I've been looking for you inside. We searched the entire village. There is no trace of Lallan and Champa. I wonder where they are. What are you doing here?
She couldn't sleep inside. I had a tough time putting her to sleep.
What's wrong? Why are you crying?
I can't be happy after slapping my daughter, can I?
You love her too. You haven't done anything wrong by punishing her for her mistake. Come on, don't be so upset. Anandi knows you too well to be angry with you.
I'm very concerned about her. To be honest, I slapped her out of fear. And not because I was angry.
Fear? What do you fear?
We have only one child. That too, a daughter. I won't let her go astray like other girls in the village. I won't let her do anything that would disgrace us. Till her husband takes her with him, I won't let her out of my sight even for a moment.
Anandi?
Come on, let's play with our dolls.
Okay. Yes. Now we'll get them married.
Yes.
Why don't you come to play with us?
Mom doesn't want me to play. Come on, let's play.
We'll get them married.
Anandi, leave this. Keep this. Let's go home. Let's go home.
Hey, Anandi, where are you these days? There was a puppet show at the town square yesterday. You never showed up.
Mom doesn't allow me to go out.
But why?
I am married now, so Mom doesn't want me to roam around in the village.
It would have been fun had you been there. Kishore started to dance in the middle of the show. The floor was wet. He fell down the moment he stepped on the floor. It was really funny.
Really?
Yes, he was screaming in pain. His face was smeared with mud. You would have got scared of him. He looked like a ghost. Seriously, a ghost. Won't you come for the puppet show next time?
Anandi? What are you doing over there? What was he saying?
Do you know? There was a puppet show in our village yesterday. He said that it was great fun.
Listen, Anandi, you shouldn't talk to these good-for-nothing boys at all. Got it? Come, just do your work. Come on.
And this is comes around Oh no, where am I going wrong? I'll have to check the total again.
That's Listen, about... I have something important to tell you.
Yes, tell me.
Listen to me.
This one... What are you doing, Bhagwati?
Listen, I know that Anandi is an obedient girl and that we have instilled good values. But then we can't trust all the boys in the village. All these boys keep looking for chances to meet Anandi. She's very immature. What if they mislead her?
You know about Champa's deeds. What if Anandi also?
You just send her to her husband's house.
Are you crazy? How can I just send her
away? Her husband belongs to an affluent family. If they hear rumors about Anandi, then they will not take time to find another girl for the son.
But Anandi will never do anything wrong. You are impossible.
But then how can you be so confident? What if something goes wrong? I suggest we should send her to her husband's house.
Listen, I don't agree with you, Bhagwati.
But then you...
Look, you want to know why I'm so confident, don't you? You know, Bhagwati, the values that parents instill in their children help them differentiate between right and wrong. Besides, you shouldn't doubt Anandi's integrity, okay?
You are right about that. But when I look at what's happening around
Close her... your eyes to it. Have faith in your daughter. Please stop worrying so much, Bhagwati. There's a right time for everything. Look, a year has passed since their wedding. The days just flew by, didn't they? The remaining 4 years will pass quickly too. We'll send Anandi to her in-law's place after that. Why are you so eager to send her away? Shower her with love and affection until then. It'll be just the two of us later on. Bhagwati? You are so silly. You insist that we send our daughter away. But you start to cry when you realize that she'll be gone. Silly woman.
I wonder when they'll send you home. I don't think it's ever going to happen. We'll keep meeting secretly like this till we grow old. What are you laughing about?
What you said was really funny.
You can make fun now. You'll regret it when I bring home a second wife.
Okay, so you plan to marry someone else, right?
Years are just passing by. I keep thinking of you all the time. But why should we stay apart in spite of being married?
So you better talk to your parents. Ask your parents to come to my place and take me away.
Sumitra?
Yes?
Pratap and his father has come here.
Really? You go. I will complete this and come there. What is it?
This isn't a casual visit.
What do you mean?
They want to take Sugna with them this month itself.
No. You just refuse them. You just go and tell them. Tell them we won't send Sugna away till she turns 18. They will want Sugna to have a baby within a year. And I don't want my daughter to go through the pain at such a young age. Whatever happened with Jabuna, I don't want Sugna to meet the same fate, and I don't want to ruin her life.
There is no need for you to worry at all, Bhairo. Your mom is still alive. I am quite experienced. Well, we have to adhere to the traditions. You just can't do everything as per what people say.
Mother, you are...
I don't want to hear anything. How long will you keep your daughter in this house? Huh? You all please go home. Start the preparations. I will talk to the priest. As soon as he fixes the date, I will inform you right away.
Uh,
as you wish. Now, we will take your leave, aunt.
You got Sugna married at a very young age, but don't send her to her in-law's place so soon.
Whatever happened with Jamuna, I don't want Sugna to meet the same fate.
Hukum Singh. Please don't mind, but I have made a decision. I have decided that you can take Sugna with you only after she turns 18. And I don't want to discuss it anymore. I'll be thankful if you agree to it. I'm willing to support my daughter all her life if you don't.
Bhairav, how can you say such a thing? Are you out of your mind?
Basant, I've said it. After due consideration, my daughter is young, and then kids. No, Basant. I would rather support Sugna all her life than see her life being ruined like this in front of me.
A married girl's life becomes a living hell if she stays with her parents instead of her husband.
My daughter is not a burden on me. I'm not going to abandon her. I have brought her up very lovingly. And I don't want her to face any problems in life.
It is all right, Bhairav. You just do what you feel is right. You have already waited very long. A little bit more won't matter. My son and your daughter are already married. And by pressurizing you, I will never let our relationship go sour in any way.
That's so kind of you, Hukum Singh.
Trust me, Bhairav.
It is our dream that our daughter goes to her husband's house and looks after his entire family.
Okay, I'll take your leave now. Let's go, son.